Hi, I'm Russell Watson on The Music Room. Now it's time to find out what our hosts have been doing as we follow Bond on A License to Thrill.
The name Bond, there's a story behind it. When we were rehearsing for one of our shows, we were actually trying to come up with a name because we didn't have a name. And there happened to be this movie, Dr. No. And we're talking about possibilities of maybe doing a John Barry-esque type track, simply because it lends itself so well to strings. Bond sort of came out of that, it was this great word, because it has so many different meanings to it. Like, you can play on it in lots of different ways, but we like to play on it in the friendship and musical bond between us. Well, that album Shine has evolved from Born quite naturally, actually, as we've sort of been on the road together for about 2 years, and I think when you're sort of with for other people in such close situation, you do grow together, and I think it's sort of, there's a more of a unified sound on this album.
Well, we did something on this album which we actually did in the first one, and we sat down together and went through kind of list of the sort of styles we wanted on this album. We actually wrote quite a few tracks together on this album as well, and that process involved, you know, writing things at home, bringing them in, talking about ideas together.
We've taken the good things from the first album, Born, which sort of like, you know, this eclectic mix of music and everything. But yeah, there is a little more ethnic stuff on this album, Shine.
There's quite a few ethnic things, but it's more... Yeah, I'd say Middle Eastern-y and slightly Indian.
You always wanted to do a Bollywood one just because it's kind of, you know, it's really eff and happy and it's very string orientated and it's good, you know, it's kind of good visually, and we were hoping to get a free holiday to India, but that didn't happen. Filmed in a studio in London, and they did it like a kind of Bollywood film set, that we had some great Indian dancers, some girls who showed us how to do some dance moves.
Fuego was different because we actually, as Shine was done in studio in London, we went on location with Fuego. Ended up in this amazing little town called La Virginia, it was designed by an architect, David Gray. He specializes in Andalusian architecture, so kind of got that really tangible, I don't know, just like there's an atmosphere, I think, that's transferred into the video, so it gives Fuego a different dimension.
We never thought this would take off the way it has, because we all were doing other things as well. And then, you know, suddenly it's become full time. Well, and we got a deal.
Fundamental.
Yeah, we were really surprised at the popularity of the first album, although obviously we were proud of it. I think it's because it's instrumental music, you don't think that it's going to sell that much, because everything these days really is geared towards vocal music, especially actually in America. But we were really surprised, and everywhere we went it just seemed to go down really well.
music of Bond is very eclectic, but at the end of the day, we also feel like, you know, we don't want to feel like we have to categorise it, you know. It's just music to be enjoyed.
That's all from this special edition of The Music Room.
Make sure you watch out for our album Shine, which has just reached number one in the classical crossover charts.